Let's find the area between two parabolas.
I want to find the area between the graph y equals x squared and the graph of y equals 1 minus x squared.
As usual, let's start by graphing.
Well, here's my coordinate plane. I'll draw a graph of y equals x squared, and the other curve is y equals 1 minus x squared. So I'll draw a downward facing parabola. There's the one side of it, and there's the other side of it.
I'll draw some rectangles to get an idea about what Riemann sum I really want to take the limit of.
So it's really the area inside here that I want to calculate. Let me draw some rectangles then for the Riemann sum that would approximate that area. All right, so there's some rectangles for the Riemann sum that would approximate the area in there. And then I can write down the heights and the widths of one of those rectangles. Let's take a look at, say, this rectangle here. Well, what's the width of that rectangle? It'll be real thin, so I'll call the width dx. And what's the height of that rectangle? Well, the top of that rectangle is on the curve 1 minus x squared, and the bottom of that rectangle is on the curve x squared. So if I take the top coordinate minus the bottom coordinate, that'll give me the height of this rectangle. The top coordinate is 1 minus x squared. The bottom y coordinate is just x squared. So this quantity is giving me the height of this rectangle.
Well, now I can write down the integral.
So I know the height and the width of these rectangles. So the thing I want to add up are the areas of those little rectangles. So I want to integrate the height, 1 minus, this is 2x squared, times the width, dx. But I'm trying to integrate from where to where, right? What are the possible x values in this region? Well, if we think about exactly where these two curves cross, right, what's the x coordinate where these curves cross? And this coordinate here is minus 1 over the square root of 2, and this coordinate is 1 over the square root of 2. So I'm going to be integrating to compute the area from x equals negative 1 over the square root of 2 up to 1 over the square root of 2. And it's this integral that'll calculate the area in between those two curves.
I can use the fundamental theorem of calculus to evaluate this integral. Let's find an antiderivative.
So what's an antiderivative of 1? Well, x is an antiderivative of 1. What's an antiderivative of 2x squared? Well, 2x to the third over 3 differentiates to 2x squared. And I'm looking for an antiderivative of a difference, so it'll be the difference of antiderivatives.
Now I'll evaluate my antiderivative at the right and left endpoints.
Right, so I have to evaluate my antiderivative at the endpoints, which are 1 over the square root of 2 and minus 1 over the square root of 2, and then take the difference. So what do I get when I plug in 1 over the square root of 2? I get 1 over the square root of 2 minus 2 times 1 over the square root of 2 to the third divided by 3. So this is what I get when I plug in x equals 1 over the square root of 2 into my antiderivative. Then I subtract what I get when I plug in negative that, which is negative 1 over the square root of 2 minus 2 times negative 1 over the square root of 2 cubed all over 3.
I can simplify this a bit.
Well, first off, I've got a quantity minus negative that same quantity. That's just two copies of this same quantity. Now, I can keep calculating this and try to simplify this even a little bit further. Now, let's keep going. So what do I have here? Well, it's 2 times 1 over the square root of 2 minus 2. And here I've got 1 over the square root of 2 to the third power. So I could write that as a half times 1 over the square root of 2. That's really three copies of the square root of 2 divided by 3. Okay, but 2 times a half, right, cancels. And then I've got a common factor of 1 over the square root of 2. So I could pull out that common factor of 1 over the square root of 2. And when I pull that out, I've got a 1 there minus a third is left. Now 2 times 1 over the square root of 2, that's just the square root of 2. And 1 minus a third, well, that's really 2/3. So what's left all over here is the square root of 2 times 2/3. This is the value of the integral and also then the area between those two curves.
Before committing to this as my final answer, I should check to see that the answer is somewhat reasonable.
Well, if we numerically approximate this, this is about 0.94.
So is a bit less than 1 square unit a reasonable answer?
Well, the region that we're interested in fits inside a rectangle of height 1 and width the square root of 2 units. The area of this rectangle is about 1.41 square units, and the area of the region we just calculated to be about 0.94 square units, right, this region inside here, and that's pretty reasonable. I mean, you know, it looks like if this thing is about 1.41 square units, it's not unreasonable to think that this is a little bit less than 1 square unit in this curved region here.
Yeah, we're really finding answers that accord with our geometric intuition.